Listening Library presents Memories and Life Lessons from the Magic Treehouse. This is the author, Mary Pope Osborne. Note to listeners, this audiobook includes a downloadable PDF containing photos from the printed book. Dedicated to Michael, Bill, and Natalie, and to the memory of our parents. Dear listeners, after nearly 30 years of seeing the world through the eyes of Jack and Annie, I decided to collect some of the insights they'd gained into a single book. As I began to gather life lessons from more than 60 Magic Treehouse adventures, I found myself connecting those lessons to experiences in my own childhood. As memories surfaced, I was surprised to realize how many seeds of the treehouse stories were planted long ago in my early life. I laughed at how peculiar I was as a child, and how my runaway imagination seemed to keep me about 2 feet off the ground at all times. Mostly I was grateful for how much my family helped me feel safe, in spite of my inordinate number of childhood fears. I hope listeners, young and old alike, will find pieces of themselves in my memories, as well as feel fortified by Jack and Annie's hard-earned wisdom and dauntless courage. I've always wished I were more like the two of them. Writing the books has given me the illusion that I am. Chapter 1. Be Glad to Be Alive. Jack grabbed one of his books about ancient Rome. He looked in the index and found Marcus Aurelius. He found the right page and read a quote from Marcus Aurelius. When you arise in the morning, think of what a precious privilege it is to be alive, to think, to enjoy, to love. No problem, whispered Jack. An excerpt from Warriors in Winter. When I was 6 and 7 years old, the children in my family had remarkable freedom. We lived in Fort Monroe, Virginia, one of the oldest army posts in the U.S. Our living area was surrounded by a moat with two tunnels that connected us to the rest of the post. In the middle of our area was a parade field bordered by spreading trees, houses built in the 1800s, and a beautiful small church called the Chapel of the Centurion. We could frequently hear its bells ringing. I loved to get up early on summer mornings with my twin brother Bill and our brother Michael, who was a year and a half younger. After breakfast, our mom would release us to the outdoors as if she were freeing birds to the wind. Sometimes we'd join up with our friend Chris and walk to the PX, which was a military department store. Before the store opened, we'd pull big cardboard boxes from its dumpster. Then we'd carry them across the empty parade field in the early light and make believe the boxes were our little houses. Now and then we'd stop and pretend to sleep in them and then continue on our way. Life lesson. If you greet the morning with joy and enthusiasm, your day can be filled with great adventures. Annie, listen, said Jack. Annie stopped talking and listened to the rustling leaves of the giant trees. More and more sounds filled the evening air. The strange, whirring voices of all the living things of Yosemite. The wind stirred the voices together, blending them into one timeless, wordless song. An excerpt from Camp Time in California. Growing up, I was afraid of many things: spiders, ants, mosquitoes, and tidal waves, to name just a few. But I was never afraid of climbing trees. Trees were my gateway into the mysterious world of nature. Our military family moved to a new house every couple of years, Wherever we landed, my brothers and I would end up in nearby trees. In Fort Monroe, we each chose our own tree. Mine was an oak tree. The boys and I thought a treehouse would be a great addition to one of our trees, but we didn't know how to build one. So we made do with grabbing hold of branches and climbing until we couldn't climb any higher. I loved it when the wind started to blow and the branches swayed and leaves quaked and whispered, and anything seemed possible. I climbed trees until I was 13. Even today, I can't pass a tree with low spreading branches without wanting to climb it. Life lesson: find your own gateway into the natural world. The rewards will last a lifetime. You have to go back to Father Laurent now, Barry, Jack said softly. He tugged on Barry's velvety ear. But we think you're a great dog. Annie, aren't you going to say goodbye to him? Annie knelt down and put her arms around Barry's giant head. He licked her as she clutched him. Tell him, Annie, Jack urged her. Annie lifted Barry's ear and whispered into it for a long time. Jack couldn't hear all that she said, but he caught the words, love and all my life. An excerpt from Dogs in the Dead of Night. One of my biggest regrets is that I was afraid of dogs as a child. I remember walking to the parade field one morning when I was 7 and spotting a neighbor's huge white dog. Even though I knew this dog was friendly, I ran to a tree and climbed it. The dog just wandered around the field while I sat high on a branch, anxiously waiting for him to go back home. Years later, I fell in love with a very old golden retriever named Teddy. He lived about 0.5 mile from a cabin my husband Will and I owned in Pennsylvania. Teddy would mysteriously appear at our door whenever we visited the cabin. One winter midnight, I saw Teddy standing in the moonlit snow. I invited him inside. I dried his cold golden fur, and soon he and I fell asleep together. At dawn, I walked Teddy outside and sent him back home. For a long time afterward, I felt as if a fairy tale prince had visited the cabin that winter night. Teddy inspired us to get our own puppy, a small terrier we named Bailey. In my mind, Teddy will always be the leader of the dog parade that has since marched through our lives. Life lesson: love dogs. Start now. Chapter 2. Discover the Magic of Books. The sound of a horse's whinny came from below. I think we're here, whispered Annie. She was still holding the castle book. Jack peeked out the window. A huge castle loomed out of the fog. Jack looked around. The treehouse was in a different oak tree. Look, said Annie. Down below, a knight on a black horse was riding by. Oh, man, said Jack. That's incredible. An excerpt from The Knight at Dawn. I remember one of the first times that the magic of reading happened to me. In first grade, I was looking at a story about a pig riding a bicycle on a sunny day. As I was figuring out the words, I imagined riding my own blue bike. I pictured riding along a dirt path near our house. And suddenly, I was the pig riding a bike on a sunny day. I felt the air and the sunlight and the excitement the pig felt as he set out on his adventure. I went from there to being a large rabbit in the Uncle Wiggily books, a pioneer girl in Little House on the Prairie, and a Japanese boy in The Big Wave. Since the day I became a pig on a bicycle, I've been thousands of creatures and people, thanks to books. Life lesson: read a book and be anything you'd like to be. Indeed, said Morgan. You have proved that you can find answers to very hard questions. She reached into the folds of her robe and took out two thin pieces of wood. A magic library card for each of you, she said. She gave one to Annie and one to Jack. Oh, man, said Jack.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.